It's as you predicted. He's been in contact with the rebel leader.
About 3.5 weeks before season 2 started, I get a phone call from one of our executive producers and directors, and he basically says, he has a very straight-to-the-point way of talking on the phone. He basically says, Connor, how are you doing? You're gonna be an action hero this year. Get buff. I think we exchanged maybe 2 more words and then he hung up. And that was all I heard. Then I read the first script about 2 weeks later and they made Ben an action hero. They threw him into the front line. It was crazy. It was a much more physical season for me this year. It feels like a totally different role, totally different part from season 1. It's been a crazy experience.
We're not safe here.
The fish heads. They're looking for you. Looking for your boy, Ben. We're on our way.
All season long, Ben's been walking a tightrope between alien and human. And the conflict with his character has been which way is he going to fall? And there's been forces pulling at him from both directions. And that's been his story all season long. And in the finale, you finally figure out which side he's fallen on. And the kind of the angst and the conflict that's driven him all season has taken another large step, and I won't say in which direction, but it's a nice kind of midpoint in Ben's storyline.
Just gonna take off without saying goodbye?
When that overlord invaded my mind, he couldn't keep his thoughts completely walled off. He'll come after me again and again.
We're gonna keep rolling, all the way to Charleston. There's a final push.
He's confused, he's not quite sure what's happening to his body, and that fear and confusion is manifesting itself. It's pushing itself out in the form of this violence and this hatred, which is also why he's so quick to grasp onto this Skitter Rebellion idea midway through the season, because it's kind of like the tentative silver lining in a very, very, very dark storm cloud. And he's very excited about that possibility, and that's why he's so enthusiastic and so blindly trusting in this red-eyed figure.
It's gonna be okay. We'll see each other again, I promise.
It's always kind of been a conflict, especially between him and his dad, where, like, why do you believe this? Why are you so sure? And even Ben can't say. It's not like he has any irrefutable proof that nobody else does. But in many ways, he's taking it on faith. And by the end of the season, you will find out whether that decision to throw himself into that will have really positive consequences or totally disastrous consequences.